Assalamualaikum and hi to Dr. Irene Aina and everyone. My name is Nurul Shafiqah binti Zainal and my matric number is D20191088079. Today, I want to talk about the reflection of my teaching video for assignment 2, BIP3073. First of all, the lesson has been conducted virtually via Google Meet and the class was held at 10 a.m. The number of students are 5 Form 2 students. The students have mixed proficiency levels and most of them are B1, which is intermediate levels. This lesson was designed explicitly for Form 2 students with intermediate level. I have decided to focus on reading skills for this lesson. The topic of lesson is the use of the article. My learning objective for this lesson is students should be able to differentiate between definite and indefinite article. At the beginning of the lesson, I greet the students by saying Assalamualaikum and good morning to them. And I'm asking them how they feel and how's their day today. The important part of this session is when I invoke the students' interest by asking them what is their understanding on nouns and also adjectives, which they have learned in their previous class. The example of the questions are, can anyone tell me what is a noun? What about adjective? And do you guys know the word a and ender? I'm asking these questions is to ensure that they can realize the relationship between noun, adjective, and also the article which they use it every day in speaking and also writing. This session is to give the opportunity for the students to warm up and also share their prior knowledge on the topic they have learned before. As we know, teaching aids are crucial in any lesson in the class. So, for the teaching aids, I use videos, pictures, and online quiz as a medium to evaluate the students' understanding of the topic they have learned on that day. For the teaching material, I use the interactive slides with a bright color such as yellow, white, and also blue to brighten up the mood for the students and make them stay focused in the class. I believe when it comes to a morning class, they tend to feel sleepy and also demotivated. So I try to instill the happy mood through my presentation slides. I can see that it really helps the student to stay focused on my class and evade them from feeling bored in the class. As I believe, an English class should be fun for the students. I also intend to focus on the students more in the teaching and learning session by asking them example and asking their understanding from time to time. I also give them a space to complete the tasks on their own. Moving on to the practice stage. I believe that teachers' ability to teach well in the class is called into question when their lesson isn't suitable for their students' proficiency level. Moreover, to ensure that the lesson is a success is when students are able to determine their understanding of the topic and are able to practice the knowledge in the tasks given by the teacher. As I mentioned before, in my set induction, I am asking them a few questions to define their prior knowledge on the related topic to the new topic they will learn later in the class. Two students respond fast to my questions and from their answers, I can see that they understand the questions. This part can help them to understand a little bit of the topic they have to learn. Moving on to the pre-lesson stage, I show them a YouTube video of a short story that emphasizes the use of article. The video is suitable for the students' proficiency level, which most of the students are in the intermediate levels. The video provides a subtitle and the illustration is fine and engaging to watch. The content of the video also explains a brief about the use of articles and helps them to understand better the meaning of article that they usually use in their speaking or writing. After they watch the video, I am moving over to the teaching and learning session, which I want the students to understand properly the use of article. According to my learning objective, I want the students to be able to differentiate the difference between definite and indefinite article. So, my lesson will be focusing on the use of every articles in English and how to use them in a sentence. Referring to my teaching video, to ensure the students understand every part of the topic, I ask them a few examples of each article. For example, can you guys give me one example of this article? At this session, I expect them to volunteer, and one of the students volunteered and give a correct example to the article. This shows that they can imply the article correctly in the future. Before I'm assigning the task to the students, I show them a picture of a woman shivering in a blanket. And in the picture, there is two sentences with different articles in them. For example, before we proceed to the exercise, I want you guys to tell me the differences between these two sentences. The students did not respond to the question immediately, and it takes me some time to ensure they respond to my question. At this point, I was scared if they did not understand the topic properly, but when they respond to the question, I feel relieved because they are actually understand the use of article. For the post-lesson stage, I give them a task using the online platform, which is quizzes. The task consists fills in the blank questions and the student have to choose the correct article according to the knowledge they learned before. This session is mostly a student-centered, and I'm only helping them if they need help from me. Then, I will discuss the answers together to avoid any confusion from them. Finally, I end the class by asking them if they have any questions about the topic, because I know maybe some of them are still confused. Because according to the task, they still quite confused a little bit. So, one of the students asks a question and I try to answer them properly to ensure they can understand accurately. Through my observation, the students enjoy and acknowledge the topic they learn in the virtual classroom. Some of the students have not responded to any of my questions due to their internet connection. And also one of the students is not actively involved in the class, and I think it is not because of the internet connection, but there must be other reasons. This accident actually usually will happen to any teacher, because there are some students having difficulties to join the class, and some of them are not properly prepared for online lessons due to many reasons. Because of this situation, it is hard for me to ensure the students can understand the topic I teach them because there is no interaction between me and the students in the class. Also, it is hard for me to acknowledge the problem if the students do not respond to my questions. Apart from that, there are also students who responded to my question but they were still confused and not confident in answering correctly to randomly thrown questions. One of my students did not even answer my question when I called out names. The other students have to volunteer as a replacement for their friends. I try to call out a name to make sure the students understand the topic, but I cannot get the response from the students. For the exercise part, only 4 students answered the quizy session because one of them had a problem with the internet connection. Most importantly, in the quiz part, there is not much interaction going on and it also got delayed because I have a problem with my internet connection. So there are a lot of problems that happen in my observation when I am conducting the lesson. As a teacher, I have to stay positive and committed to my profession and always ready to face any upcoming problem, especially when it involves my students. In my teaching video, students are passive in the class as it due to the factor the class was conducted online and the students are not ready for the class. As I know, most of them live in a rural area and it's difficult for them to get a better internet connection. As a result, they keep in and out of the class multiple times and cannot focus on the lesson properly. Apart from that, I also do not prepare in advance for the upcoming problem that will occur when I am conducting the class. For example, I am having problem with my internet connection when I want to assign the task to the students. Most importantly, the task is an online task using the Quizzes website. I have to drag the time to ensure that I can assign the task to the students as I have to evaluate them. I also noticed that I do not have enough information for the students to understand better the topic I want to teach them. So, they are still confused and cannot get the proper knowledge about the use of article. This is the reason why they are not responding to my question and they need time to think of the answers. As a teacher, I know that the students are mostly at an intermediate level and need me to guide them. I should give a detailed information with a lot of different examples for the students. The more important thing is I should use simple words because the students might not catch the important information regarding the topic they have learned. By reflecting on my teaching video, I believe that I could do a better lesson by fixing several mistakes that I have done in this lesson and coming up with a solution to the problem. First of all, I know that some of my students are having difficulties with their internet connection due to the place they live. What I can do to fix this problem is by doing a recorded version of my teaching lesson for them and posting it on WhatsApp or Telegram group. I think this is one of the ways that I can help the students to be able to get the important knowledge for their future. I also should give a few teachings material that I will use in the class later, especially the slide as a preview for them, so they will get ready before the class starts. Second, I need to ensure that I prepare the worksheet version of my task as I may face a problem with the internet connection. Same as my students, they may face the same problem and I can give them the worksheet in the WhatsApp group in advance if the students cannot enter the online version such as quizzes or Kahoot. I don't want my students to feel left out or feel demotivated because they cannot join the quizzes session. And it is better for me to prepare everything in advance so that I can conduct the lesson smoothly for my students. Lastly, as a teacher, it is crucial for me to give detailed information to my students. The information I give them should cover all the topic I teach, as they may be confused if I skip some part of the information. Apart from that, a good example is also important for the students. They may refer to the example I showed them. So, a good quality and variety of examples will help the student to understand better the topic they need to learn in the class. Based on the critical incident that I have experienced during my teaching session, I believe that everything that happened taught me to be a better person, especially in my profession as a teacher. The critical incident that took place have given me an opportunity to reflect on my own teaching styles and my skills that will help the students' learning abilities. The student need me as their teacher, and it is my duty to always be prepared for upcoming challenges that I have to face in the future. I realized that I should give the opportunity to my students to always interact with me by asking questions to me. I also should give my priority more to the learner's knowledge as it is will help me to create a better lesson plan for them. The students should understand what topic I teach them because they will use the knowledge in the future. The flow of my lesson plan must have developed from the set induction until the post lesson. With a better lesson plan, the students can stimulate the learning progress in the classroom. Moreover, I have to ensure that my knowledge is unlimited to help the students because I believe teacher is the main source of knowledge for the student in the class. So, I have to take this seriously and have to improve my knowledge from time to time. Finally, based on the critical incident that happened, I have to shift the environment of my class and be creative while conducting the class. Students can easily get distracted when it comes to online classes. So the teaching and talk session has to be fun for the students, because for me, English class should be fun with a lot of interaction from the students and also the teachers. And that's all from me. Thank you for listening.